știi cum îi cheamă.
Numele, dă-mi numele! Vine numele!
E doar o chestiune de timp, tot ai să-mi spui. Urbrand, fii rezonat în viața ta, nu aia ta! Mi-aparține. Mi-aparține.
Eu aparțin Hristos.
Mie mi-aparține. Mie. 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 Ardea-l.
My name is Richard Wurmbrand. I was brought up in a family with no religion. My childhood was bitter. When I was 14, I was as much an atheist as the communists are today. But I had the grace to be one of the chosen of God for reasons that I do not understand. These reasons have nothing to do with my character, because my character was very bad. But I longed from the first day of my conversion to be able to witness to the Russians. The Russians are raised from childhood in atheism. I promised God that I would dedicate my life to these people, to give them back their personalities, and to give them faith in Christ. Beginning August 23, 1944, 1 million Russian troops entered my country. The communists took power, and then began a nightmare. Atheism became the official state religion. To proclaim Christ publicly became reason enough for arrest and torture. Spies were everywhere. Church leaders had a choice. Either be enlisted in the service of the Soviets or go to jail. The communists skillfully seduced the church, and the church leaders were easily deceived. They convened a Congress of Cults for all ministers, pastors, and rabbis. Joseph Stalin was appointed as honorary patron.
În timp ce România se îndreaptă către un progres inevitabil, vom adăuga în acest panteon al personalităților istoriei pe Darwin, pe Nietzsche, pe Hegel și, desigur, pe Marx.
The Congress was broadcast across the nation. The idea was to persuade the public of the communist intent to cooperate fully with the churches. My wife, Sabina, and I watched as religious leaders, one after another, took the podium and spoke words assuring the communists of the loyalty of the church.
It is happening here just as it did in Russia.
And our glorious new Romanian government is in favor of faith, any faith. They are even going to increase the pay of the clergy.
Lenin defended the church until he came to power. Then tens of thousands of Christians die in concentration camps.
This is madness. They are spitting in the face of Christ. Will you not worship this ship?
Este exact ceea ce Dumnezeul nostru consideră că trebuie făcut în aceste zile ale noastre.
You do know that if I speak now, you will have no husband.
Calea pe care ne-o indică și pe care a mers marele partid bolșevic, al condus
de marele... I don't need a coward for a husband.
...conducător Iosif Vissarionovich Stalin. Este calea pe care și noi, cu toții, trebuie să o străbatem. Este calea colectivizării, calea electrificării, calea industrializării țării noastre.
Scuzați-mă, aș dori să iau cuvântul.
Scrie un bilet ca toți ceilalți și așteaptă-ți rândul.
Da, sau aș putea să cobor acum.
Îl cunoști pe omul ăsta?
Da, Richard Wurmbrand, pastor luteran, foarte respectat.
Wurmbrand? Nu o să ne facă probleme, nu?
Nu. Cred că susținerea unui reprezentant al Consiliului Mondial al Bisericilor ar ajuta.
În continuare, îl vom asculta pe pastorul Richard Wurmbrand, luteran, reprezentând misiunea Bisericii Suedeze și Ordinul Mondial al Bisericilor.
Dragi prieteni, ne-am adunat astăzi aici ca Sfânta Preoțime a lui Dumnezeu să preaslăvim numele lui Hristos, nu partidul. Comunismul i-a transformat pe frații noștri în martiri.
Cum ar putea fi lăudat? Datoria noastră nu este să susținem puterile lumii care din
și pleacă. Datoria noastră
este să preamărim numele lui Dumnezeu, a tot Creatorul și a lui
Hristos, Mântuitorul, care a murit pentru noi pe cruce.
Iisus a fost retras.
Iisus a fost batjocurit de cei care sunt iubiți.
Wurmbrand,
mai fă un miracol.
Wurmbrand, ajunge.
I-ai salvat pe alții și nu te poți salva pe tine.
Ajunge.
Miracolul a fost.
Tăiați-i microfonul.
Că deși l-au bătut și
l-au
cinciuit.
Ajunge.
Iisus e Italia.
Tăiați-i microfonul. Imediat.
Sigura sa, pastor!
Our churches had to deal with a new reality. The Russians were here, and they weren't going away. The registered churches were no longer safe. But we still wanted to share Christ's love with our fellow Romanians, and to the occupying Russian soldiers. Even my son Mihai and his friends got involved. They managed to learn a small handful of Russian words.
Давай, пошли отсюда, попрощайки, цыгане.
Пожалуйста.
God bless you.
You got gum from the officers again?
Mm-hmm.
Did you give them a blessing?
And the flower.
Tatăl nostru,
binecuvântează acești ofițeri prin cuvintele copiilor noștri. Amin.
Amin.
As time went on, the communists tightened their grip even more. Bibles were banned. Churches were monitored. And everyone was watching. The communists knew that faith in God was the only effective resistance left. As members of the body of Christ, we were committed to helping even the communists come to the light of Christ.
Stai că începe cu Marx aici. Pagina albă, pagina albă. Da.
Nu? Da.
Și iată. Foarte tare. Foarte inteligent.
Nu?
Ai văzut? Marx pe copertă? Pe pagini sus.
Da.
Lucian ar trebui să fie politician, să știi.
Da.
Și rimează. Păi, hai să le punem undeva.
Da, da, da.
God will not judge us according to how much we have endured, but how much we could love. We love the Russians so much that we risked everything to bring them the gospel.
Da?
I spoke Russian fluently, and for me to preach to the Russian people was heaven on earth.
Noroc. Ceasul, ceas.
Здравствуйте. Bine, nu?
The Russians were very fond of watches. They stole them from everyone. They never had them before, and now they could not get enough of them. A Romanian who wished to have a watch had to go to the barracks of the Soviet army to buy them. They were often buying their own watches back, but we saw this as an opportunity to share the gospel.
Nu puteți să luați ceasurile oamenilor și după aceea să cereți bani pe ele.
Aici să, aici să, tomoja tatlicit. Adina Drugova. Но для тебя я сделаю специальное предложение. 50 лей.
50 лей? 50 de lei, asta e hoție pe față. Cam ești picioarele.
Ia, dă-mi ceas.
Nu e ăsta ceasul meu. Ăsta e ceasul meu. Oh,
что у вас сегодня? Что-нибудь хорошее?
Лучшая коллекция. Что ты думаешь?
Это не годится. У вас есть что-нибудь другое?
Я не вижу то, что я ищу. Там должны быть и другие. У меня есть вопрос. Кого-нибудь из вас зовут Петр или Павел?
Да-да.
Ты знаешь, что ваша православная церковь имеет специальный день, когда прославляют святого Петра и Павла?
Ты знаешь, кем Петр и Павел были? No?
Ты не пришел сюда, чтобы купить час. Все нормально.
Once the soldiers realized that we were there to speak about God and the Bible, they would close the doors and gather in close. It was extremely dangerous.
Ну.
But they were so eager to learn more.
Петр, он был рабочим человеком, рыбаком.
Пока не встретим человека по имени Иисус.
Петр и Павел провели всю жизнь, рассказывая другим, что Сын Божий пришел, чтобы простить их грехи и сделать для них путь к жизни вечной.
Пока не встретим человека по
имени Иисус. Nanny came to Christ, and we were able to distribute thousands of gospels in this way.
Провели всю жизнь, рассказывая другим, что...
Of course, the joy of winning one to Christ is always mixed with the feeling that there is a price to be paid.
Хорошо, я тебе дам 50 лей.
Sadly, a number of our brothers and sisters were caught and severely beaten. But they did not betray our work. We were meeting an entirely new type of Christian, the Christian of the underground church. Carried on the work of Christ, just as in the days of the apostles. And we met in our homes. We were always wary of spying eyes that came from everywhere. Our ministry to the Russians was bearing fruit. There was one young soldier named Peter. He had come with the Russian army. It was not enough for Peter to accept Christ. He wanted to be baptized.
Петр Радманович Ковалев, я крещу тебя во имя Отца и Сына и Святого Духа.
Baptisms were very risky. There were so many informers among us, and only the most trusted could be invited. But Peter insisted, and we had complied. Our underground church was modest in size, but it was growing in numbers and in courage. After being baptized, Peter risked his life smuggling Bibles to other Russians. He was an example to many of the new believers.
Пожалуйста, будь осторожен. Ты знаешь, что произойдет, если бы тебя поймали? К тебе будут относиться худше, чем к румынским верующим. Если это вообще возможно.
Если бы моя жизнь не была моей, я ушел бы уже. Но все мы принадлежим Христу, не так же? Ты сам установил пример.
Last I heard of Peter, he had been arrested and sent to prison. Whether he's already in heaven or continuing the good fight on earth, I do not know. But Peter had courageously served, and we had learned a new lesson. Every soul won for Christ must also be made a soul winner, no matter the cost.
You know what? I think you should perform the wedding. And I'll just play on the streets all day,
No.
No? No?
No.
Okay. See you at the church in 1 hour, okay?
I just won.
If I go now, I might be there before you.
Don't make us wait for you.
Am I ever late, dear?
No. The rest of us are just always early.
True.
Sabina worried about me being late for the wedding. And not without some merit. I was easily distracted, especially by those most innocent among us.
La più mare? Ehi, vedi la mia, come ti chiamo? Come ti chiamo?
On that day, Sabina was right to worry. I would be late. I knew where I was going. This type of kidnapping had become common.
Scuzați-mă!
Nu vorbi!
Aș vrea să vă pun o întrebare.
Nu-ți răspundem la nimic.
Lasă întrebi ce mai contează. Ce zi e azi?
Ce?
Data. Aș vrea să știu ce dată e azi.
Ăsta nici n-am mâncat bătaie că ești deja.
I had discovered 366 verses in the Bible that instruct us not to fear. One for each day of the year. And even one for leap year.
Știi cine suntem?
Da.
Deci știi unde mergi?
Da.
Tot ce vrei să știi e ce dată e azi.
29 februarie.
It was a leap year. February 29th, 1948. I remember the verse for this day. Psalm 56, verse 3. What time I am afraid, I will trust in thee.
Ai ținut un discurs foarte interesant la congres. Cred că ai o grămadă de prieteni. Prieteni care te ajută. Nu? Poate facem o înțelegere. Tu îmi dai niște nume, îmi spui cum îi cheamă. Și poate te ajut și eu. Nu-mi place să te torturez. Dar pot să te împușc.
Domnule colonel, spui că poți să mă împuști. Știu că poți.
Pot.
Dar dacă mă omor, eu mă duc la cel pe care îl iubesc. Există Dumnezeu. Și există viață veșnică.
A noi nu suntem niște criminali, niște naziști. Noi vrem să trăiești. Și să suferi. Am să-ți fac cunoștință cu tovarășul Brânzaru. Tovarășul Brânzaru.
Ai văzut vreodată o carceră? O să-ți placă.
We were forced to stand in wooden boxes, only slightly larger than we were. Sharp nails were driven into every side of the box. We stood for endless hours, sometimes even days. I don't like to speak much about our horrific suffering. When I speak of it, I don't sleep at night.
Zi-mă un nume ceva! Dar ia mai gândește-te tu un pic, hai! Până atunci îți arăt niște jucării. Asta e pentru măseluși.
I remember one pastor named Florescu. communists wanted the names of his congregation. But he refused to betray his brothers and sisters. But he died with the name of Jesus on his lips. Our dear brother Florescu was never the same after witnessing his son's death. Who could be? Solitary confinement. I had only my thoughts for company. But I had God. I remembered what the martyr Savonarola wrote. He said, "There are two kinds of Christians. Those who sincerely believe in God, and those who just as sincerely believe that they believe." Did I believe in God? Now the test had come. Every night, when the 10 p.m. bell signals time to sleep, I begin my nightly routine, beginning with prayer. Prayer, of course, was forbidden.
Iartă-i rogi, mă.
Sabina was also arrested. The secret police came in the middle of the night, accusing her of hiding weapons in our apartment.
Deschide ușa! Sabina Gurbrand! Știm că ascunzi arme aici.
Nici o armă aici. Asta este singura armă pe care o avem. Lăsați-mă să mă rog și am să merg cu voi. Our dear father. You have said that we are persecuted but not abandoned. So please do not abandon us now. May our suffering glorify you. And through it all, might we shine forth your love. Amen.
Sabina, along with thousands of other political prisoners, was put to work digging a canal that was supposed to connect the Black Sea to the Danube River. The canal was considered to be a symbol of great communist achievement. Some communist engineers tried to warn the party leaders that the canal, as designed, wouldn't work. Those engineers were shot. Today's quota was to move 8 cubic yards of dirt per woman, in any condition. Every day, Sabina would repeat a scripture, and often it would wind its way through the whole camp.
Laudați-L pe Domnul că cel e bun și mâna sa e veșnică. Laudați-L pe Domnul.
Gata cu vorba!
Trebuie să fie sâmbătă. Trebuie să fie sâmbătă. Îl bat pe adventiștii de
slăbșoară. Ura,
was my only escape. The beatings would not prevent me from talking with God. My wife and my son were always in my prayers. It's how I held them close.
Pastor.
Acum a trebuit să te speli.
Arunc o durere.
Unde-i Dumnezeu tău acum, a? De ce nu te-a salvat?
Dar m-a salvat. Cu mâinile tale m-a salvat.
Sabina broke two ribs when she hit the rocks in the Denim River that day. The women suffered greatly, and many died in the labor camps.
Fericiți cei săraci cu Duhul.
Whenever they moved me from cell to cell, I would always find other believers. Naturally, preaching in prison was strictly forbidden. It was never an issue of if you would be caught. It was only a matter of how bad the beatings would be when you were.
Oate! Iar predici! Hai! Ce faceți? Nu i-ați schimbat foarte bine! Nu mă zic, bă, băiatule, predici! Uite că te-ai împiedici!
I have witnessed many times where a brother was dragged from our cell to the beating room because he was preaching. He would be kicked, cut, beaten with sticks, and all kinds of tortures.
Unde am rămas? Fericiți cei prigoniți pentru dreptate. Aceea acelora este împărăția cerurilor.
We didn't stop preaching. We'd made a deal with the guards. We would preach, they would beat. Everyone was happy. My feet were beaten so often and so brutally, I would never walk normally again.
Nici un pic de milă.
Să faci o omletă, trebuie să spargi niște ouă.
Așa spune și Lenin.
Se spart eu. Nu simți nimic. Sunt ființe umane. Orice lovitură doare.
Nu-mi pasă. Dumnezeu nu există. Așa că nu există pedeapsă pentru rău. Îi mulțumesc Dumnezeului în care nu cred că trăiesc astăzi să pot exprima tot răul din sufletul meu.
I am sorry if a crocodile eats a man, but I cannot reproach the crocodile. I had learned the same can be said of my torturers. Communism had stripped them of any form of humanity, and they sank into unthinkable depths of cruelty. Darkness ruled their every action, and only God's love could restore them.
Iar te rogi? Ești tâmpit! Băiatul tău nu mai are casă! Nevastă ta e arestată! Viața ta e distrusă, mă, băiatule, și tu te rogi în continuare la Dumnezeul al tău care nici măcar n-are chip! Pentru ce căcat te mai rogi, mă? Pentru ce te mai rogi tu acum?
Mă rugam pentru tine.
While in prison, I contracted a severe case of tuberculosis. In those days, TB was often a death sentence. And I was moved to a prison in the Carpathian Mountains. If a prisoner took a turn for the worse here, he was sent to room 4. Nobody had ever returned from room 4 alive.
Așa e.
Dumnezeu este pastorul meu? Atunci de ce mai am nevoie? Dacă El vrea să stau întins în patul ăsta, cine sunt eu să-L contrazic?
Some who preached in the prisons had been pastors. But most were lay people who were simply inspired by the Holy Spirit. One such man was named Matkevich. He was extremely sick. Somehow his family found out how sick he was and sent medicine that could save his life.
Veste bună, Matkevich! A venit un pachet pentru tine. Cu medicamente. Haide! No! Doar el.
Thank you.
Eu nu am voie să le dau medicamente deținuților. Dar dacă mă ajuți, ți le dau și ai să trăiești.
The officer wanted the same thing they always wanted. Names.
Eu nu sunt trădător.
Da? Bravo! Iubesc soldații curajoși.
He told Matkevich others were talking. And their reports even led to his many beatings.
Hristos ne-a învățat să ne iubim dușmanii. Eu nu pot răspunde la rău cu rău.
Matkevich died in my presence. I watched him enter eternity while praising God. I saw many men die in that room. And here is a remarkable fact. Not one died an atheist. None of them died without making his peace with God and man. Many entered room 4 as firmly convinced unbelievers. But I saw their unbelief collapse always in the face of death. Just as many men think themselves religious and are not, so some think they are atheists without being so. After her release, Sabina had no idea if I was alive or dead. Until one day, a friend found me in room 4. Dr. Luigi was underground and undercover. He had become a Christian and wanted to renounce the Communist Party, but we begged him to stay in and find a way to serve Christ. His sacrifice was the greatest of all of us, for even his family and friends believed he had betrayed God and gone back to the party.
Von Braun, is that you? I heard you had died.
Maybe tomorrow.
Sabina will be relieved then, at least for another day.
Can you get a message to her?
I can.
Tell her I'm alive. Tell her I love her. Tell her God is here. Ask her if she might deliver some pork ribs with polenta. The kitchen here is dreadful.
Don't look well, Richard.
My soul sings. My body not so much.
TB is no joke. You need medicines. I'll try to get you some.
Then try to get some for all of us.
Without medicines, you will die.
They told me I had 2 weeks many months ago.
I have lost the count of the days.
Є вже проблема, докторе?
Єстем. Ярде фронта. Are nevoie de medicamente, dacă nu...
Moare? Aici toți mor. Asta e camera numărul 4.
The communist ideology is nothing other than the religion of Satan on earth, as one who passed through communist prisons called it. It claimed hundreds of thousands of victims among us. It did not succeed, however, in breaking those who, not wanting to lose their souls, held steadfast with all their being to Christ, enduring horrible suffering, and finally, dying at the hands of the communists. They acquired the crown of glory. To be in the same cell with great saints, heroes of faith who equaled the Christians of the first century. They tithed their tiny rations, giving it to the weakest prisoner. They shared communion with the little they had. They faithfully witnessed to their torturers. They would gladly die for Christ. Even our chains became musical instruments, and we worshiped the Lord together. Supernatural became the natural. I have seen such beautiful things. Spent 14 years in prison, for many of which I could not see the stars, birds, or even a butterfly. And I still love the Russians, even the communists, with all my heart. They can kill Christians, but they cannot kill our love. I hate the communist system, but I love the men. We had experienced a new form of Christianity, the kind where Christ's love conquers all.